Hi, everybody. Welcome. It is March the, I don't even know, it's Wednesday, March 6th. So I'm glad that you guys could join me here at Quilt of Joy. We have a lot of great things for you planned in this edition of the Quilt of Joy Clubhouse, and I'm just thankful that you have chosen to spend a little bit of time with me. So hopefully you are watching either on Facebook or over on YouTube, and do know that we record all of these Clubhouse shows, so you can go back and rewatch them at your leisure if you're not able to join with me live. And as always, you can add things there to the chat, and I'd love to hear your thoughts about whatever we talk about. So today, really, I would like to know, we just had Leap Day. And first, do you know anyone who was born on Leap Day? I'd really be curious to know. They're called Leaplings. I didn't know that till this year. Put down there if you know anyone who was born on Leap Year. I think that's kind of cool. I saw somebody mention that their dad turned, I think it was like 10 or something. So if you know a Leapling, put it in there. And then, of course, it was an extra day for 2024. So put there in the comments what you got to do on your extra day of the year. So we had a great group come in and do a sit and sew here at Quilted Joy. And we had a little bit of fun just playing on the machines, and they were creating their own projects. And it was just a nice day to kind of enjoy an extra day of sewing. So I hope that you had a good leap day as well. So pop over there in the comments and let me know what you got to do and if you know any Leaplings. And I did want to be sure that you are signed up for our Quilted Joy newsletter. And we certainly put everything that you need to know about Quilted Joy in our newsletter, and we remind you of any upcoming events. So there should be, Jesse, can you make sure there's a screen there with the bit.ly link on how to get to our newsletter sign up?
Absolutely.
Because we put in any events that we have coming up, any announcements that we have coming up, and we have a lot of stuff coming up for you. So I want to be sure that you have everything, all the information that you need, and it's all in there. And I also wanted to tell you, there's a super exciting event, and we're gonna be rolling out this week all of the information about this event that's coming up. And so pay attention to our social media feeds, pay attention to our newsletter, pay attention to our website, because I am hosting a week-long trip to Bavaria and Austria for Christmas. It'll be that first week of December, and it's with the Love of Quilting group, and it's all through craft tours, and we are going to go spend a week at the Christmas market in Bavaria, and we are going to have there's an optional apple strudel cooking session. I'll be teaching a class. There's a really limited number of folks who can go with me on this trip. And we're going to have links on our website and in social media and in our newsletter that'll take you to all of the information where you can see the rundown of everything that we're going to do. But I sure would love for you to join me in Bavaria. I've not been to Bavaria. I've been to Germany. I've been to Dusseldorf. I've been to Austria, and I'm trying to remember, it's the major city in Austria, and that name's running out of my head right now, and spent a lot of time in the big cathedral there, as one is wont to do. But I've not been to the Bavaria area, and I've not been to the side of Austria that's just right across the border there, the Germany, Austria border. So I think it's limited to, I don't know what the max amount is, but anyway, if you're interested, do take a look. And what I might do is, I've got a couple of folks helping me today that, aren't normally in the positions they're in. And so I think I'm going to actually, Tara is, helping with our comments today. And I'm just going to, Tara, I'm going to find that Bavaria, link for you, so that you can pop it into the chat, because I think people are going to really want to, know about it. So I'm sending this over to Tara, and she's going to put it in the chat and take a look at this international, this Bavarian. It just, the pictures are so amazing. I can't wait. And if you would like to join me on this trip, I would love for you to join me. It's through Craft Tours. So they've been around a long time. You've probably heard of them before. The other thing I wanted you to know is that in March, just like every month, we have a new thread pack. And this month, it is the Pansy Pixie. And the Pansy Pixie, isn't it pretty? The Pansy Pixie has three different Glide colors in it. It's got lime and nectar and paisley, and they are so pretty together. They do look like a little pansy, and we have these at a special price only for the month of March. So once March is gone, our Pansy Pixie will fly away, and we'll have a new quilt fairy that visits us. And we do have this available in both the king cone size and the mini cone size. It's a nice way to kind of build your stash over time, but those are three beautiful colors there in our Pansy Pixie group. And then we have a second bus going to the Paducah Quilt Show. The first bus sold out in like 5 days, and we only have a few spots left on the second magic bus going to Paducah. It's gonna be so much fun. And we do have early bird pricing through March the 14th, and it's $159. After March, so on March 15th, it'll go up to $179. Now, the bus will leave from the Quilt of Joy parking lot at 7 a.m. It'll return at 10 p.m. And we will have some water and light snacks on the bus. The price includes admission to the Paducah Quilt Show. It includes a show book. It includes gratuity for the bus driver. And we're going to have some giveaways and a little bit of fun on the bus as well. So it's going to be a blast. I hope that you are able to join us. It is for Thursday, April 24th from Louisville, Kentucky to the Paducah Quilt Show. If you are coming to the Paducah Quilt Show from another destination that's not Louisville, that's not on the bus, please do stop by the Quilted Joy booth there at Paducah. When you get there, we would love to see you and say hello. We also, excuse me, we're going to have our Looky Loo tours. Another general call out for folks to volunteer for our Looky Loo tour. So it's just a time for the two of us to do a little video chat. You give me a tour of your sewing space, and I sure would love to see what you have going on in your sewing room. It's a little bit of fun to be nosy and poke your head around someone's sewing room and see how they have themselves organized. So do sign up to volunteer for one of our Looky Loos. And then the other big news I had to tell you is that APQS, we have an APQS long arm trade-in event where we actually are offering up to $4,000 off non-APQS machines. So if you have a different brand machine, I've had a lot of folks with 10 Lizzies call me recently. If you have a different brand machine and you are looking to trade in the past, I could not accept non-APQS machines for trade-in. And so with this event, we could accept even non-APQS machines for our trade-in event. So there's some information down there in the description that'll take you to the link where you can go and find out more information about our APQS trade-in event. And then we do have our Secret Meadow quilt kit that has launched. So the 25th anniversary of the Love of Quilting magazine, they asked me to design their commemorative quilt. And they're rolling it out as a mystery. So the first half of the mystery was in this month's edition of Love of Quilting magazine. And the next half of the pattern will be in the following edition of Love of Quilting magazine. And we are the exclusive provider of the kit for this quilt. And it's a big quilt. It's a 96 by 96, if memory serves, quilt. And it features some gorgeous fabric from Riley Blake. It's the Porch Swing line from Riley Blake. It's just beautiful fabric. So pop over to Quilt of Joy and take a look. There should be a link there in the description to take you over to our Secret Meadow kit as well. And then if you are looking for some long arm quilting education, so perhaps you have a long arm machine and you need to kind of know how to use it better, we do have a beginning long arm class, and that is taught through Zoom, and that will be on March 15th. And if you've purchased an APQS long arm machine from a dealer or a store, In the last year, that class is free for you. And so if you would like for us to add you to the credentials, you're allowed to take that class one time, whether you have taken it from a different shop, you can just take it one time. But if you haven't had your APQS beginners class, your beginning long arm class, I'd love to have you join me in the classroom. Just send us an email here at Quilted Joy. You can send it to support@quiltedjoy.com. And we can work on getting those needed credentials for you. If you have a different brand long arm machine and you would like to take the class, I have loads of people who take this class who have other brand long arm machines. You can sign up for the class there on our website, and I will see you in the classroom. I do record that class so that you can watch it later. And there's certainly, we have the chat open, so lots of questions come through. And there's a mountain of downloadables that I give you as well during that class. So hopefully you can join me for that. And then finally, we're going to have a sit and sew on March 19th, and that's at 1 o'clock Eastern. So that's Wednesday, March 19th. We'll meet again here in the clubhouse, and I'm going to go through some fun, interesting blocks for you with the pattern. We're going to take a look at some different ways to piece a block and a pattern for you. So take a look at that. And we have all of those past sit and sews as well up on YouTube if you want to watch them as well. All right. So does anybody know any leaplings what did they do on leap day, Tara?
Barb's
son's best friend is a leapling. Nice. He turned seven. That's sweet. Yeah. Wouldn't that be fun? That would be so fun. I read that in New Zealand, I guess their gas pumps weren't, the computers behind the gas pumps didn't know leap year existed. So you would think every 4 years they would get it together, but apparently they're new, and so nobody could get gas in New Zealand on leap day. So it's one of those events that happens every 4 years that kind of catches us all off guard. But I love that he's seven. That's fantastic. Anybody else?
Deborah knows a few leaplings.
Deborah, you know a few? You know a few leaplings? That's surprising. That's pretty darn cool, though. My bonus daughter, she is a OB nurse in Cincinnati, and I forgot to ask her if she was working on leap day to see if she knows any new leaplings. I'll have to ask her that the next time I see her. Anybody else? Yeah. All right. And anybody say what they did on their bonus day of the year, on their leap day of the year? Hopefully you were sewing. That was on my list of things to do that day as well. All right. So in 2024, we have a number of different educational ideas that we're going to roll out each month, and it's all around sashing designs and different easy sashing designs. Sashings can be a little bit challenging because it's such a small space to quilt within. So I've got some 5 easy peasy sashing designs to show you. We recorded this earlier with the machine so that you can learn a few new sashing designs for your next quilt. We're going to do super easy loops, just lowercase L's, lowercase L's, lowercase L's. And one of the challenges to this is getting that spacing correct, because sometimes they can get further apart, sometimes they can get closer together. So if you put little lines and then keep your L's on those lines, you will have nice straight and tall loopy L's. But now I think I'm going to mix in, the next one I want to show you mixes in a lowercase e in that kind of empty space. So if I go with a lowercase e and then a lowercase l and a lowercase e and then a lowercase l, that is another super easy, really fun beginner sashing design. All right, so now let's take it one step further. And I just want to stack these. So I'm just going to do a lowercase e. I'm going to do a few here. So I'm going to do one on the line and one between the line. All right, so that's the next one I want to do. Okay, so I've come out here. And now let's, I'm actually going to break my thread. So this would be a two pass easy peasy beginning sashing. So we've done the little lowercase e's. I've done a number of them. So let's play with a different design, and I'm going to start up here in the top of my sashing space, and I'm just going to just mirror that. So I'm going to just take some tacking stitches here, and I'm just going to mirror it. So I'm going to go So I'm just stacking them on top of each other. the same thing I just did. And that would get me the E's, lowercase E's, which is another easy peasy sashing. So, okay, so I'm up to, let's see, 1, 2, and then stack them is 3. So let's, I'm just gonna break my threads, because the other thing you can do is you can actually put these in shapes as well. And so on the space right above this area, I just have chalked out, well, they're just diagonal lines. And so I just want you to see how you can use these, because they grow and shrink. And I'm not gonna stitch out those diagonal lines. I'm just gonna have my E's and my L's grow into that space that I have chalked out. All right, and so I'm gonna sneak over here. All right, here's the next one. So maybe we'll do 2 of these. And now we're using loops. There are all, you could ribbon candy, you could do wishbones, but I think loops, if you're looking for a good, easy beginner design, this is it. It's with loops. Okay, so I would keep on going on my quilt, and I just want you to see that that would give you this kind of up and down, which would be super interesting in a design, but let's stack it. Let's do a mirror design of it. So I'm gonna come over and do a second pass of this. I'm gonna bring my bobbin thread up to the top, and I'm going to start out, and I'm going to do those same loops. So I'm just going to loop, and I'm just going to stay away from what I just stitched. So it's going to make it go a little smaller, and then I'm going to sneak through, and I'm going to do it on this side. So I've got this chevron, this alternating chevron, and it's kind of a ghosted chevron, but once you get loops down with your machine, you can have a whole lot of fun. Let's keep on going, because they're just really super, super versatile. All right, so we're going to take a look at, I'm going to keep on going, and we're going to take a look at how this all stacks up. You would do all around your quilt, inner border or sashing, kind of the same thing, but these would be a good beginner. All right, so that's one other variation. Now let's go back, and I just want to go back to those same lowercase E's, and I just want to show you a little fun thing that you can do with a lowercase E. So let's see, I'm going to bring my thread up here, and I'm gonna go lowercase E, 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 E. And then when I get to the end, I'm gonna head back over. And it's just a little bunny hop. And I wanna touch the line of my E. So it's like E's in a little, they're like in a little picket fence. So let's do it one more time, because I wanna actually fill it up. I'm not sure if this will work or not. So you and I will be on a journey here together. So I'm gonna come back over. It's a little hard to do this with a camera. All right, and so I'm kind of liking that, but I'm feeling like maybe, all right, so take a look and see what you think. I'm feeling like maybe one more little pass would kind of build that up. One of the things you'll see, if you see where your eye's kind of drawn to symmetry that isn't exactly alike, if you add one more line, sometimes it'll really help the eye kind of be drawn away from any kind of asymmetry. So I'm just building. So there you go. So that would be echoed E's. They're kind of like in a little rainbow bridge there with them. Let's put some more E's in this space down here, and I'm gonna make these kind of drawn out, because I want you to see how we can kind of have a little fun. I'm gonna sneak up here to the top, and I'm just gonna drop one now in between as I head back, and that would be a whole other design. So I wouldn't mix these two designs that are sitting here side by side, but I just wanted you to see the difference between E's that are stacked on top of each other, like these, versus E's that are spread apart and they go alternating. I think one has a little more whimsical, almost contemporary vibe to it, and the other one could go a little bit more formal. And of course, we just put little loops in there, but I want you to imagine if those were pointed loops or if those were leaves or hearts or goodness, anything, circles. There's all kinds of opportunities here to build sashing designs. Once you have that flow down, get the loops, concentrate on that for your first sashing foray into free motion. All right, so those are some five easy peasy sashings for you to play on your machine from day one and get good results. I sure would love to see if you use any of those sashing designs on any of your upcoming quilts. Go over to the Quilted Joy Clubhouse and post a photo there in our Facebook group. I sure would like to see how you use those designs on your quilts. Draw them out first and then take them to the machine, but it's a really good place to start. So hopefully you found some food for thought there and a little bit of inspiration as well. Now, I was stitching on our APQS Millie, and I do want to thank our sponsor, APQS. They are 100% handcrafted there in Iowa. They're loved the world over, and APQS machines come with a lifetime warranty. Now, APQS had a baby. We have a brand new APQS machine. It's the Sweet Ellie. She is an 18-inch throat machine on a halo frame. She only needs, it's a 5-foot table. So if I have a lot of people who say, I'd love to have a longer machine. I don't have the room. Ellie is a great choice because she's just not very big. And she does come with that lifetime warranty. And she has a stitch regulator. She comes with that hoop frame. That halo frame. So if you are interested in learning more about Sweet Ellie, just give us a call here at Quilted Joy. You can also contact your local APQS dealer or your local APQS store. But I would love to chat with you a little bit more about APQS machines. And remember, if you are interested in any of those APQS machines right now, I can offer you a trade-in on any brand machine that you have. So if you've got a machine that you are looking to move up from into an APQS machine, I can offer you a trade-in on any brand right now. So give us a call and we'd love to get you connected with an APQS machine. Okay, so for our looky-loo, this time we're going to spend a little time with Cheree Hull at Morning Latte Quilts and take a look at all of her amazing storage ideas. Hi, Cheree. Thank you so much for joining me today.
Hello. Thank you for having me.
So where are you? What state are you in?
I am in Kansas, Wichita, Kansas.
Nice. And then are you in a home? Are you in a basement? Are you where's your sewing room?
My studio is in the upstairs of our home. I get to stay home. I'm a huge homebody. I love it up here.
Fantastic. So it's an extra bedroom?
It is actually, okay. This actually used to be my bedroom when I was younger. my parents built this house when I was in high school. And so we are, we're in a property that's like 100, it's been in my family for like 120 some years. So we bought this house from my mom. And yeah, I joke around that I'm still in my bedroom from when I was in high school.
That's so great.
But yeah, it's a guest room right now.
So. All right, well, I can't wait to see it. Can you turn the camera around so we can see?
I can. Okay. This is how I enter in the morning. This is kind of the overall scan.
Nice. Oh, it's beautiful. I love how you put that fat quarter stack up on that little stool. That's so stinking cute.
Little inspiration in the morning. So yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
And then you've got a Lucy there. What size frame is that?
This is the 12 foot.
The 12 foot. Nice. Up against all that bright light coming in.
Yes.
And then do you have like a cushy pad there on the floor that you stand on?
Well, no, not so much. It's just to kind of cover the cords.
The cords, stuff, so. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
And then you've got your big screen TV in the back there where you can watch whatever you want. What are you typically watching while you sew?
I am typically watching, I'm keeping up on everybody in the quilt world. Gosh, just about everybody, but mostly tutorials and podcasts, you name it. So
awesome. Yes. Awesome. All right. Keep on going.
All right, we will start over here. This is where I keep my thread collection. I am a very neutral person. I like to keep very neutral threads, so it's pretty small. All the maintenance for my machine that I can roll around in that cart.
Perfect.
We have a Jack and Jill bathroom up here between two bedrooms. So I have a vanity, which is a little, you know, unusual for a quilt studio, but gives me access to water for like my iron and so forth. So,
Yeah.
So down here is what, this is where kind of my go-tos for backings. I'm a clearance shopper. So I'm always picking up stuff that I think might work for backings on quilts.
And so you're piecing your backings. Those are all 45s, right?
I typically piece my backings, and I when I make time for it, I love to put actual blocks and stuff in my back because I think it's more interesting. So I don't think piecing backings so much. So I have two closets up here. I don't know if you can see the other one from over there, but this is where I keep, like, this one has some of my batting, has some of my quilts. Basic storage. I'm a knitter also whenever I get time. So there's some yarn up there, but again, more batting.
And is the batting just sitting there on the cardboard tube, or do you have it like threaded, the cardboard tube threaded into something on wheels?
No, it is just sitting there. I pull it out.
And then those are quilts waiting to be quilted?
No, those are already quilted. Those are quilts I have for sale.
Nice.
They look kind of boring, I guess, because you're seeing the backs of most of those, but because I fold, you know, inside out. But
all right, well, thanks for showing us your closet. Yeah. Do we get to see one too?
Well, I could, but it's boring. But I have some black batting and some other things back in there. So,
all righty.
So over here, I have where I store my batting. Yeah, I got my batting scraps under there. That's something I need to work on. Okay, so here are what I would call my long arm supplies, rulers, and so forth. Mm-hmm. Not too special. The majority of my fabrics that I piece from are in this cabinet. This is IKEA stuff.
Yummy that way. It looks like little, all by color.
And then I keep fat quarters in a drawer and so forth. Let's see, an extra table for when I have to cut out borders and so forth. And then I'm going to skip over here. Yeah. This is my other cabinet.
Is it lit from the inside? Did I see it?
I was going to show you that. I bought a Christmas LED lights that I have put in there so that, you know, I want to see my fabric. So those are kind of mounted up in there.
I love the colander and with the jelly roll and the little scrap jar. So cute.
Trying to be creative. So
And
A little bit of scraps. I'm not a huge scrap keeper. I usually purge it at the beginning of every year, but I haven't really done too much of that this year. Anyway. Alrighty. So the main where I really hang out are back here. I have two chalkboards where I kind of just write everything I come up with, like watching the quilt tutorials and so forth. I scribble everything on those. So those are like my inspiration boards, I guess, if you want to call it. This is actually two cubbies. This is my cutting station. It's actually two cubbies put together. I don't know if you can see the seam in there. That's another IKEA thing. And it's got these cubbies in it that you can buy different inserts and stuff for. So you can customize it as you want. This is where I keep what I'm working on. Usually I've got fabric, you know, for my current project and so forth in there, keeping it handy. This is like my new thing right here. Down below. Well,
are those bolts? Are those full bolts? So it goes, the cubbies like connect together?
Because I've got two of them back to back.
Does
that make sense? I know it's kind of hard to explain.
Okay. Yeah. So they're the the 1 foot cubbies and you got it back to back. So they're open. Right. The two are connected that way. Got it.
Right.
That's so smart.
So down below I have what I would call like my background fabrics and maybe some solids and so forth. That's kind of where I keep all those. My other, like I said, my other stuff. Keep some of my templates. I don't know if you can see those hanging on. They're on like little magnet hooks.
Oh yeah,
right there.
Yeah, I like how you've got your rotary cutters hanging there too, so they can stay out of your way and you don't hit them with your hand.
Yeah. This is something my husband helped me do. I have two of these, one on each side of the window where I keep mm-hmm. my rulers. I've got to have mm-hmm. everything up and out of my way, but handy. So yeah. I've got another one over here. So I just took one of these. I painted it, mounted it on the racks. And
I see. Yeah. So. Nice.
All right.
Nice.
Down here, this is my mobile ironing station. You know, like if you're piecing something that needs ironed every 2 seconds.
Sure.
That's, I kind of pull that over to my sewing station, you know, so I'm not up and down so much. Yeah. So, and then I've got go ahead.
So while you're, cause your long arm machine is computerized. So while it's stitching, you can be over here piecing a quilt.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. So yeah, I typically sit right here, look out at my TV and my long arm.
I love your little kingdom. What is on the leg of your piecing table there, right below you? What is, it's like wrapped around the leg. What is that?
That's my cat scratcher. It's for my cat. Keeps her off of everything else.
Can you scratch here, not over there?
Exactly. So
Funny. Yeah. Well, so can you turn the camera around, Cheree, so we can see you?
There we go.
Thank you so much for showing me your space. I love that you're in your childhood bedroom and you have converted it to a swanky studio for your sewing needs. That's so great. Well, Cheree,
it is my happy place.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Yeah. So if you, are there three things that you would suggest to your bestie right now? They don't have to be quilt related, but three things that you're kind of into that you could share with us.
Sure. Okay, well, one thing that is quilty is I'm very much into red this year. Usually I don't pick a color, but reds are my thing. So I'm thinking it's going to be maybe a red and ivory Irish chain next or something, but totally anything with reds.
Quilt behind you with the,
that one.
Beautiful. Yeah.
Thank you. And I'm also into reading about history. I've had a couple reads lately that have been fantastic by Mark Sullivan, one being The Last Green Valley and the other Beneath a Scarlet Sky. So those have been, they've brought me to tears. They have been fantastic and they are based on true stories. So let me think. And one more, I guess just golf.
Yeah.
Just golf. I love the golf. So get out there and golf.
Even in the wintertime, you're out there in Kansas in the winter golfing? Yes. Are you?
Yes. My cutoff for golf is about 35, 40 degrees. I will go when it's
Well, Cheree, thank you so much for spending a little time with me today. And if people want to connect with you, they can find you over in the Quilt of Joy Clubhouse, right?
Yes. Yes,
they can. All right. All right. We'll see you there.
All righty.
Okay,
thanks
bye-bye.
For stopping in. Bye-bye.
Isn't it fun to see in someone's space? Thank you so much for letting us take a little tour, Cheree. And I really love how you took those IKEA units and gave them a whole new purpose. So I appreciate your time. And don't forget, you can go and visit Cheree if you'd like to connect with her more. She's got an Instagram account, and then you could check her out on her Etsy shop or her blog. So we've got those links down there in the description if you want to go and hang out with Cheree a little bit more. You can do that there. And of course, I would love to spend some time with you on a looky-loo tour. So if you would like to volunteer to record a looky-loo tour where I can join you on a video chat and you can show me around your sewing space, I sure would love it. We do pre-record them so that everybody's blood pressure goes down. So don't worry about feeling like you have to be live or something. We can stop and start. But if you go down there in the description, there's a link where you can go and volunteer for a looky-loo, and I would love to get a tour of your sewing space. We do have some new arrivals here at Quilt of Joy that I wanted to show you, and one of the ones that we're the most excited about is our Fuzzy Love Quilt Kit, and it is in the January-February edition of Love of Quilting magazine, and it features all these great kitties. We also have an embellishment kit, so if you want to pick up some chenille for the whiskers and some cutesy buttons for the noses, you might enjoy our embellishment kit. And that is all for the Fuzzy Love quilt. And we're gonna be talking about that again here in just a minute. We also got some new fabrics from Moda N just this morning. It's our confetti ombre fabric, and we got the best of the confetti ombre fabric. That's the name of the line. And they're just absolutely gorgeous. They're modus, they're high quality cotton. You can find those over on the website. There's a link down there in the description, so do check those out. And then I also brought in, so we got some really awesome, these are cards, blank note cards with a quilty look, and these are by the Ruby Star Society. They were designed by Jen Hewitt, and we've got a link down there in the description if you wanna go check these out. There's a set of 12 in the package, and they're nice because they're not a specific, you know, a thank you card or a birthday card or something. They can be used for anything, but they have that quilty look to them. So really awesome from Ruby Star. And then we have some really great project bags that are all CAFE project bags. They're different sizes. There's a link down there in the description. So all of these have a zipper, and then they are kind of a vinyl on the outside, so easy to keep clean. And then they have a bright interior, so you can see what the heck is inside them when you go to open them up. And so there's different sizes. So there's that smaller one. There's this medium size project bag. It's 14 inches by 10 inches. Look at the inside. One of the things that I get frustrated a lot of times is if you open up a bag, you can't see all the way in it because it's dark in there. So having that bright lining really does help. And then check out this big one. This one, let's see what it says, is 18 by 13. So it also has a strap inside here. So you see the little buckles up there. So there's a strap that you add to the buckle, so it is over the shoulder, and then it does zip down pretty far, and look at how far you can see into that one. So that's the big project bag, and those are all CAFE designed, and they're really beautiful. So they make a good gift, but they also make a good gift for yourself too, right? So there's a link down there in the description if you want to see those. And I would ask that if there's anything that you have gotten out of our time together, that you have learned something or had a little fun, if you would review us over on Google. Being a small business, and especially a quilt shop, Google doesn't know who to serve us up to. So the more people who leave us reviews, it allows us to grow our audience and be exposed to more people and have the Google algorithm decide that they want to show us. So I do read each and every review, and I appreciate your time when you leave it, and it does help us grow, which also helps us serve you. So leave a review for us over in Google. Of course, the best possible compliment you could give us would be to share this with a friend. So if you have a friend that you know would enjoy the Quilted Joy Clubhouse show, please send this on to them so that they can watch in the future with us. All right, so every month we take a quilt, and I show you how I would quilt it if it were my quilt. And I told you about this quilt that's behind me, the Fuzzy Love quilt, and how much fun I had with this, and that it's in the January-February edition, and we do have it as a kit. But I wanted to just show you how I quilted the Fuzzy Love quilt. So I've got it up here on my screen. And this is just showing you the piecing of it. So let's zoom in a little bit. So I'm gonna zoom in here. And of course, one of the great things about this quilt is that you can make this, you know, to your kitties, however you want it. This is just how I did it. So I'm gonna zoom in here a little bit more so you can see, and it's a pretty big block. If memory serves, it's like a 16 inch block. So the first thing that I did is I just went ahead, and because I didn't wanna, like, you could do an all over edge to edge, but remember that what I have on these, I have chenille whiskers and button noses. So you definitely want to quilt this before you go adding, for sure, the buttons. You could get by with adding the chenille first, but I did not do an all over edge to edge. I actually did custom quilting on this because of all of those embellishments. So the first thing that I did is I did go around the ditch just to emphasize my kitties. And I went with each cat so that each cat I went ahead and did the stitch in the ditch for each cat. So the path for that, let me just take this off and show you the path. So the path I did, I would have chosen like an intersection here to go out and up for an ear and over for the forehead and up for the ear and down. And I probably went back up and then over here. Don't be afraid when you are stitching to travel twice on a line if you need to. I think we feel like sometimes that we're in this like game show where we have to figure out the continuous path and can't go anything over twice. The only thing I would say is if you're gonna go over something twice, go over everything twice. So for example, here, by going over that line twice where I started, then I know that that has had two lines of stitching, just like everything else. And then I would go ahead here and just go ahead and give the noses of the cats a little bit of definition as well. And so that is how I would go through. That is the path I would use to ditch each of those. Now, notice that I wound up here. I'm going to create a new layer just to show you. So notice that I wound up right here. And so I chose that start and stop area for a deliberate reason. And that's because that gives me a place to dip in and deal with this interior of my kitty cats. And I'm just going to change the color that I'm doing, because I want you to see that I would have gone through and just now my piecing does this for me. The seams are here for me, so I don't have to actually mark, but I'm just putting some little dash lines so that you can see where those seams are, because it's really easy now. I'm just going to drop in with a lowercase loopy E and out, and then a lowercase loopy E and out, and a lowercase loopy E and out, and a lowercase loopy E and out, and I will finish then where I started. And so that is what I did on the insides of all of my kitties there. And then what I did on the around the outside is I just really felt like that, you know, kitties play with yarn. Like, I didn't wanna make this too over the top. I could have done a whole bunch, like originally I thought about this space here. See how this is like it could be a block on point in there that I could do something. I could go in and really just repeat what I did in those little guys here in the outside. I'm just gonna do it really fast. But I decided not to really overthink this. Instead, I just did loopies. So almost like, you know, the cats are playing with the yarn. And this is one of those designs that you probably learned at some point. It's a pretty common design. And it's just, the only secret is that whichever way you enter, so if you notice on this one, I entered in that direction. So the secret is whichever way you enter this loop, so that way I went clockwise, then the next loop, I want to go the opposite direction. And that is how you travel. So if this design has kind of flummoxed you in the past, it's likely because you're not changing the direction with each loop. So you need to have something in your head. If you don't have something in your head as you do this design, it's gonna kind of get away from you. So I generally go clockwise, counterclockwise. You could go north, south, like have something in your brain as you travel around. And of course I did this on my long arm, but this is a great design you can do easily on a sit down machine as well. And so I just did it here. I'm gonna zoom out so you can see. I basically did it on my long arm machine in rows of cats and filled in my loopy design and just traveled all over and then rolled it forward and moved and just did this entire swath all together. Now the hearts that I put in this design, I actually went ahead and with that chenille outlined the heart. So the hearts have a fuzzy outline to them. And then what I would do is just go in and just quilt a heart inside of them. I didn't want to do too much because I really liked the fabric, the little kitty cats in the heart, super fun. And then in this design, one of the things that I built into it, so I kept everything super simple and just let the cats do the talking. But if you notice, do you notice how this top border here is pretty big? Like when you look at the side border, it's narrower than the top border. So the top border and the bottom border are bigger than the side border. And that's pretty different. Normally you would have all four borders the same size, but the reason I did that is to give myself plenty of room here in the top and the bottom to stitch all of my little kitties' names. And so I went through and I changed thread. So in the bulk of the quilt, I use a gray thread that kind of blends, but up on their kitty names, so one of the kitties, I just did it with cursive handwriting. So on one of my kitties' names, I did, I'm not gonna be able to do it here because my computer can't keep up with my quick movements, but I'm gonna see if I can. I did Oscar. Yeah, my computer's like, I can't write that fast. So I did Oscar, and now Oscar, he has a nickname. We call him Boo Boo. So I've got his proper name up here at the top, and then on the bottom border, I stitched in pink variegated thread, of course, his nickname, which is Boo Boo. And so Boo Boo is here, and then up here I put Luna, and Luna's nickname is Tuna. So I just had a whole lot of fun making this very specific to my kitties. And Jesse, do you have a photo of it done?
I do.
Shot of it. I'm not sure if there's any photos there of Oscar, Boo Boo, Tuna, Miss Tuna.
Unfortunately, I don't see any of
those. No, okay. And then I went through and even the kitties that have passed on, I went ahead and added all of those to that outside border as well. So just, it's a really easy block. It's a really easy quilt to do as well. The piecing of it is super simple. But the kit that we have put together for you has all those fun kitty fabrics, little fishy fabrics, little kitty fabrics. So we just had a whole lot of fun pulling together this kit for you. So if you make it, I would love to see it, you guys. And I would love to know about your kitty name. So put them, if you do make it, put it over there in the Quilted Joy Clubhouse so that I can see what you're looking, what you made. All right, let's take a look at our show and tells that have been in the Clubhouse this month. And these are quilts that people have posted in our Quilted Joy Clubhouse. I would love for you to join us in our Facebook group. I would love to see what you are working on. Karen posted this one. She said, here's what happens when my almost 12-year-old grandson says, Grandma, do you have time to make me a quilt? So yeah, Karen, the answer is always yes, right? Yeah. She says, this is my first use of dot-to-dot planning for the quilting pattern. It was really fun, and I'm pleased with the results. I hope he likes it. I finished it up last week, and it's in the mail. He requested blue and white. He said I could pick the rest, and it was a January-February project. Now, take a look at how she quilted that with those strong diagonal lines. Doesn't that really give a lot of structure to that quilt? I really love the straight line quilting that you did here, Karen. Nice job. All right, Virginia posted this one. She said she's put two on here. So we're looking at Virginia's first one. She says some more things that she's done this past month is two matching quilts for a grandbaby that's due in April. The small one he'll get right away. The large one will be saved for when he's older. So I don't know if you've ever done this or heard about this, but people will make two quilts, a small one for a baby quilt, and then that larger one will be put away, and they'll have a version of their baby quilt later in life. That's a little bit bigger to snuggle with, which is such a sweet, sweet idea, Virginia. Again, look at those straight lines that Virginia did and how she used those, the strong piecing lines and just echoed those in that negative space. Sometimes that giant negative space that you have there, that those big white swaths, Virginia, can be intimidating, but you just broke it down and kind of continued the piecing with the quilting design and just extended it out through that negative space. Great use of quilting to complement the piecing, Virginia. Nice job. And then Virginia also posted this one. She says, this was a scrappy chandelier quilt that won first place in my Quilt Guild's Pink Quilt Challenge. She says, I was more excited about my fellow quilters' praise than the prize. Isn't that the truth? And then again, that straight line quilting in those diamonds on point, it just does look like a chandelier. It looks really, really beautiful. And then I guess, Virginia, is that the back on the upper left corner? That must be the back that you did. What a great back. So nice job, Virginia. Thanks for posting that. And then Jennifer, she said this is her compass quilt. It's a full size quilt in the yellow, and she's never made one before. And this was the first time making this. It was foundation piecing on interfacing, and that she watched a video and picked up the clues on how to make it right away. So thank you so much, Jennifer. Good job. It's really beautiful, striking. All right, and then Michael put two on here. So Michael said that he's been on a picnic quilt kick and that he really loves the backing for these two. The smaller one is more for a tablecloth, and the larger one, we'll see here in a minute, is big enough. Ooh, I went forward, hold on, there. And the bigger one is enough to sit upon. And with each quilt, he says he's getting better with the binding. He tried transparent thread in the bobbin recently and was pleased with the results. And he says the beauty of getting into quilting in my fourth quarter is that I can do what makes me happy. Isn't that the truth? I love the backing fabric you did on that too, Michael. We had that, I've forgotten who makes that backing fabric, but it's giant blooms on the back. They're really gorgeous. Nice job, Michael. All right, and then Linda, she posted this. She said, Happy Valentine's Day, everyone. This is one that she quilted lighter on the hearts and heavier on the rest, and it kind of makes the heart jump and look 3D. So, and then she's got all of the little, you've got some pretty baubles in that heart-shaped dish, but I can see where little chocolates would also be wonderful on that table runner, Linda. Thanks for sharing that with us. And then Judy said that she just thought she'd post some pictures of her loopy hearts and that she has done this on smaller borders as well. And it's one of her go-to designs. So thank you so much. Thank you so much, Judy, for posting that. And Judy said that she did the border of a blue preemie pinwheel quilt, and she's donating this to her guild community project. And isn't that sweet with the jungle fabric? And Jennifer, she said that she made this Ginger Larson Bentley, and she had never done foundation piecing before, but it came out pretty awesome. Oh, this was the bigger one that she was referring to earlier. Yeah, very nice. And doesn't it look at home on a room with, you know, wood on the walls. Really pretty. And then Michael posted that one. He said, when I retired, I started working on unfinished quilts for my grandmother. This was the most fragmented, 2 1/3 of these large flowers. He said, I quilted the quilt top and Quilted Joy completed the quilt, including the binding. And last week I quilted these pillow tops for shams to match. I reduced the size of the flower and completed the pillow covers today. And I'm really happy that they turned out. And Michael says, Quilted Joy is true to their name. Aw, thanks, Michael. That's a great pantograph pattern to go over that. I'm so glad that you were able to finish up your grandmother's quilts. Well, thank you so much for posting your quilts there in the Quilted Joy Clubhouse. And I would love to see what you are working on. The Quilted Joy Clubhouse on Facebook is our private Facebook group, and it's full of the nicest, kindest quilters who are just looking for a way to support you and celebrate you and answer any questions and help. So I hope that you can join us over there in the Quilted Joy Clubhouse. Now, in April, we will not have an April Clubhouse. That first week of April, I am traveling. I am actually going to go to Vegas, and I have Miranda Lambert tickets, and I'm going to just go like have a little vacay. So no Clubhouse in April, but do join us over on Facebook, on our Quilted Joy Facebook group and our Quilted Joy Instagram account. And then of course you can find all of the previous Quilted Joy Clubhouse recordings over on YouTube. And then don't forget to join me for our sit and sew on Wednesday, March the 19th at 1:00 Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific. And I hope that you guys have a wonderful March, and I'll see you in a couple of weeks at our sit and sew. All right, you guys have a great day. I'll talk to you later. Bye.